Well, hey, folks. Well, guess what? Bones is out of hibernation. Yes, it's Bones Tracks Day 50, and he has moved. And he's moved quite a distance, but I'm not sure how far, so we gotta go find him. But first, I want to show you where he spent the winter. Check this out. As you may remember, he spent the winter very close to this old rotten pine log that's about 3 feet thick. Right at the base of this mount wall under these leaves. But now, what did the chamber look like where he slept? Let's take a look. Here you can see a little hole where he dug himself out. This little access way. And right inside, believe it or not, there it is. That was his hibernation spot. It's right there. Just barely big enough for me to put my hand in, or a small fox turtle. Only about 3 inches under the leaves. Not very deep at all. It's just absolutely amazing that all he needed was this little bit of insulation to survive. I'm gonna cover it back up because who knows? He might use this year after year. And I guess, and I hope we will find that information out when he goes back into hibernation in 6 or 7 months. Amazing. It is just amazing to me that an animal can sleep underground for 7 months without eating, without drinking. Incredible. I mean, and only under about 3 inches of leaves. You know, the temperature had to get really cold down there. Although the soil temperature itself stays pretty constant year round, but still, there were probably days when it got really cold, but yet, the amazing box turtle can survive incredible extremes. And here we go. This is proof that box turtles are amazing creatures and they deserve protection. They deserve respect. And hopefully through my videos, you're gonna gain a little bit more respect and admiration for this tiny creature that spends its entire life in such a small area. This is its entire universe. This is all Bones knows. This is his life. This is his whole entire world. And that is why places like this need to be protected. There needs to be wild lands. There needs to be undeveloped tracts of land where animals can exist. Away from human intervention, away from human machines, away from humans. And you might say, well, they're not away from you, you've got a transmitter stuck on a shell. Well, true, but not forever. Only for a few years to learn the secrets, to hopefully learn some really interesting information that can help people manage their lands to preserve these creatures, to give them habitat, to give them a place to live. So this is a good thing. So join me on Bones Tracks Day 50 and let's find out where he went. Isn't that what we all want to know? Where's Bones? So let's go.
Aha!
And there he is. Right beside that old stump. Let's take a closer look at him. Hey, Bones. Haven't seen you in a while. Are you out here foraging after this little rainstorm came through last night? You look great. Look at those eyes. Red as ever. Transmitter still looks good. Well, I'm going to have to weigh you and find out how much you weigh, see how much weight you've lost over the winter. I'll do that in just a minute. But well, Bones is sitting here, only about 20 feet from the driveway, in a blueberry patch. Yeah, blueberries, mountain laurels, pretty much the standard habitat for this little box turtle. All right, I'm going to weigh Bones now. I'm going to make this as quick as possible, so not to stress him out too much, but it has to be done. I only have to weigh him once every month or so. Scale, plastic bag, best thing I can use, very lightweight. Quickly place him in it, weigh him, take him out, put him back exactly where I picked him up from, and then wash the bag very well, because I don't want to transmit any diseases from Bones to the next turtle. Here we go. Okay, first I have to check him over, make sure he's okay from his hibernation. Looks fine. I don't see any odd damage or anything. Transmitter is still firmly attached. Okay. Into the bag. Come out and say hello, Bones. He usually likes the camera. He's peeking out. He looks great. Look at you there, little buddy. You look really, really great. Bright eyes. Face is all dirty now. Hopefully that's a good sign that he's been foraging around this dead stump over here. So, Bones is out of hibernation. That's awesome. Now we get to follow him around for a full year from coming out of hibernation to going in. And we'll get to see what he does, where he goes, what he eats, hopefully, and more. You know, and I have a feeling it's going to reveal some really great information about this little box turtle on this piece of wonderful land here in Cedar Mountain, North Carolina. Get ready for Bones Tracks 2008.